Greetings from DMS College of Engineering, Bangalore. This is an introductory module. Just to state what made us venture into this initiative. I am Kanmani, working in the Department of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering, BMS College of Engineering, Bangalore. And my interest in signals and systems and signal processing commenced during my engineering college days, because we had a very good faculty, Dr. Chandramouli. Dr. Chandramouli of V.R. Siddhartha Engineering College of Engineering, Vijayawada. I owe to him for having instilled in me the passion in this course. How I wish he were alive to see this day. Later on, my first employment with KL College of Engineering, Guntur. It's interesting to note that they were looking for a teacher who could teach signals and systems, and that's how I got my first job there. Moving further, my PhD interview with the Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. I was asked questions on the impulse response, convolution, correlation, etc. And again, it helped me get admission into the IISc for my PhD program. And since 1995, I am here with BMS College of Engineering. And I have been teaching various courses, but I somehow enjoy teaching courses on analog signal processing or the digital signal processing. If we look at the contents, the contents of the course, this module we are focusing mainly on digital signal processing. However, it is very closely related to another prerequisite course, which is signals and systems. It is taught in this manner. The signals and systems course followed by the digital signal processing. In general, by and large, this is a sequence that universities adopt in delivering the two courses. And moving from one institution to the other, there will not be significant change in the course content. And coming to the reference book or textbooks, there are numerous textbooks available for anybody interested to read and gain the knowledge. And similarly, we also have a lot of online courses being offered in this area, in the area of signal processing. So an interested student can take any mode of updating his knowledge, his or her knowledge. Even though we have good, rich content present in various forms and different sequences, the presentation style from one textbook to the other varies, and it depends primarily on the manner the author wants to present the content. The content is similar, but the sequence and the presentation style and the notation also changes from one author to the other, or from one textbook to the other. Now, even though we have a lot of content, we always need a teacher. We need a teacher, for helping us understand the course. So this is what we attempt in the module. The modules, we try to present a few lectures. Like the lectures are typical, modules are typically what I have been teaching the students every year. So more or less the same content is presented in the modules here. Because this is a course where we need a teacher to explain the content that is present in the textbook. It is usually not a course for self-study. And it is that role of the teacher. Mine, as I mentioned, every faculty have their own style of presentation. And I resort to some sequence, and that is what I'm planning to share here. And I would like to make it very clear that these modules are not a replacement for the prescribed textbook. Every student is suggested and recommended to follow the books that have been prescribed by the university or the institution. So this is just to help understand the concepts of the course. Now coming to the content that is going to be covered. We will have modules that are going to address maybe the sampling theorem. We start off with the sampling theorem. Few modules on sampling theorem. We also have a representation of LTI systems as another topic. We then have the methods of evaluating the convolution sum as another topic. Then we have the discrete Fourier transform, understanding and computing the discrete Fourier transform. We then shall see design of FIR filters. And then it will be followed by design of IIR filters. And the course will conclude with a brief introduction to wavelets. Yes, the course concludes with an introduction to wavelets. And we have around 4 to 5 modules for each of the topics listed. And most concepts, concepts shall be supported with the simple lab experiments. Experiments to help understand the concept so that we have a clear understanding of every topic that is being addressed. For lab implementation, we will use the MATLAB programming environment, and also we will be using the multisim. The multisim environment for circuit simulation examples, whereas we use MATLAB for the MATLAB programming environment. So these are the two modules. Again, our programming examples or our implementation is not to understand MATLAB or to understand multisim, but our aim is to understand the concepts of signal processing, the digital signal processing. And hence, we will to a large extent try to avoid using the inbuilt functions, and we will try to convert the theory that we learned in the course, the equations, into a suitable code and try to observe the results. That's how the courses are designed. We will also include simple examples, taking audio or suitable audio files so that it makes the learning interesting. Now for recording these video modules, we are using the GoToMeeting platform. The GoToMeeting platform, which we have been in our department, all of us are using this platform for the online delivery of the lectures. Now I would like to add here that we are not having a professional studio environment with a good acoustic system, nor do we have allocated dedicated teaching assistants or a support system. It's me who normally delivers the lecture to the students through the online platform. The same, it's me trying to record the lectures for these concept videos in the domain of digital signal processing. And in moving, I would also like to, I remember a few incidents that have helped me further gain the knowledge in this domain. And here I would like to mention interaction or the opportunity I had with Professor Mark Yoder. Yoder of Rose-Hulman University. He has written a book on DSP first. So wherein they propose the idea that teaching DSP first before teaching signals and systems enhances student learning. It was a real good experience that I had interacting with him and of course going through the book. I would also like to recollect the opportunity I had in meeting and interacting Professor Sydney Burris. Sydney Burris of Rice University, and I have attended the complete course on signals and systems, the 5-day course on signals and systems by Sydney Burris, and the way he presented the concepts and how he ensured that we remember the concept by giving small real examples and stories of his students made the learning of the course interesting. And he also introduced me to the platform on cnx.org, which is an open source resource for uploading any content. And another memorable moment has been my opportunity to meet Professor Simon Haken. During one of the IEEE DSP SP signal processing conferences. I mean, I have been following his books on signal processing, signals and system, digital communication, analog communication. I never imagined I would get an opportunity to meet him. And my whole career is based on most of my learning that I've gained from his books. So these are some of the moments which I recall today. And I have always enjoyed my teaching. Every interaction with my students has been memorable, and the interactions, the questions that they raise during the lectures is what makes teaching interesting and fun for both the faculty and the support received from BMS College of Engineering, the management, the faculty colleagues and the student is amazing. The environment they have provided for professional growth it cannot be described in words. I owe everything, all of my professional career accomplishment to the environment provided by the college. So, to mention a few references that I have referred to for this course. One is the Signals and Systems by Simon Haken's and Barry Van Veen, Wiley publication. Another reference that I have used is the Communication Systems by B.P. Lattie. And the other is Digital Signal Processing by Oppenheim and Schiffer. And the Theory and Applications of Digital Signal Processing by Rabiner and Gold. These are some of the references that I have referred to in preparing content for the various modules on digital signal processing. Any feedback? Looking forward to any feedback for improvement or suggestions. Please send a please send mail to bkanmani.tce@bmsce.ac.in. So thank you. Hope the modules will be useful, and any feedback, any suggestions for improvement is always welcome. And of course, if there are any errors, please help me correct it. Thank you. Since the recording of the modules is not done, I would also like to mention that the modules are recorded in my chamber in the normal environment, and hence that there's likely to be some background noise, some disturbance. And I am also using this pad for writing. This is the pad on which I'm trying to write. And sometimes this pad also creates some problems. So the writing is not so free. On some days, the movement of the pen is not so smooth, and hence there are small hitches in using this tool as well. So with all this environment, this is an attempt to share the content, the teaching that I've been doing all these years. The simple reason is this pandemic has actually collapsed the borders of the classroom. And now our lectures have gone to the homes of the students, of our students. So we thought, why not our lectures go to the homes of other students as well. With this in mind, an attempt to record the lecture modules in the concepts of digital signal processing has been made. And we hope this content will be useful to the listener. Thank you. And each of these modules are going to be of about 1 hour in duration.